Ta-da! Here I am. Welcome to what is supposedly to be my tutorial videos. That is something I've been looking forward to do for actually a long time. I know a lot of people have like asked me for it, but it's not been that easy to like understand how to actually proceed with it. I'm not really a video guy, but well, here I am. So for the first video I'm gonna show you a track or a method actually that can be utilized to build tracks for you. I mean, it sounds really fancy, but it's actually kind of what's happening here. So I created I took a lot of different LFOs that FL Studio has, and I also built my own devices in this thing called dashboard, and then I just apply some various things that I know from like computer science, PCBs, electricity science, everything, how like circuitry works, not exactly in the sense how it works, but like the principles of it, and call and response and different kinds of logic and gates, etc. But a lot of people are wondering like how and why would I even want to choose to use this? And this is a philosophical question that I actually have had for a long time during my live sets all over the world. Is something, when I play those live sets with Fruit Loops, it's like I play, it's me playing. I'm listening to what I think is worth to listen to, or like what's interesting. But I come to a point, especially when I'm alone, where it's like I don't really care about what I think anymore. It's not even that interesting after a while. I'm like kind of tired of like me, like why do I choose to like layer this kick drum here? Like, I don't care really. Like, what I find more interesting nowadays is what this video is about, actually, like to build a system that you can take out values from the system and then apply it to different kind of things. For example, things that turn on and off, or how the oscillators, sliders move in a synthesizer, or like anything for that matter, send effects, basically anything you can take and choose these signals for. And why I choose to build it inside of Fruity Loops instead of like doing it in code outside is, I mean, that's quite obvious. Then I can just use the signals right there. And recently I also realized that even though I've been using Fruit Loops since 2003, there are still things I don't know shit about in this program, which is the nice thing of it, I guess, making music in a big music program, you can't know everything. Anyway, I think we should start to break down this track, which actually doesn't have a name. But this system is designed to make psytrance at the moment. It could make anything, like we could use these signals to make like ambient, also techno for that matter, but we might need to quantize the signals a bit more. That's the thing, like you need to know, you need to have a goal with this. If you do something like this, like you're building like a person, a next person that has ideas from you, me in this case, like I built how it moves and how it behaves. I also decide if it's gonna behave more or less. And that is like a thing that I really find interesting, like to make music like a game almost. In this system, the only thing I need to do in order to change the appearance of the track at the moment, or like, actually that was the other system maybe, but maybe not this one entirely, but like I just need to change like the rhythm settings, the pulse setting, the rate setting of the LFO. For example, if I have 10 LFOs controlling things, I can just change the rate on two of those LFOs and put them in a completely different quantized number. And the whole structure of like all the sounds that are layered completely change, and the rhythm of it changes, and how they behave together change, and I find it very interesting. And it's a technique which I haven't utilized at all before, and now I can already see in the future, if there is any future, playing live again, but I can see in the future that I totally redesign my live sets to actually use this person, let's call it person, to use this assistance in my... I already see that this a system like this, that is maybe more integrated and well integrated into the project, could actually do a whole live set for me, or like do every detail for like 2 hours, and I don't need to do anything. I don't need even need to think. I just need to like think how to like change it in a cool way. I find this very interesting. I mean, that's what I find interesting, and that's what this video is about. So, let's get into it. All right. Here we are. You might see already that there are a few things here that resembles a track, but I can assure you that it's not a track here. And what I mean with that is these automations here that we should just rule out first what they are doing, because the other stuff here is actually what I was talking about for almost 10 minutes. So we just have a bunch of actual automations here. I wouldn't say they are really important for the general structure that I was talking about before. These are like what I call like simple automations. They are just composed of like volumes that are being attenuated like in the beginning of the track and in the end. And here are actually three LFO values, but they are just slightly changing. I don't think they actually do so much. So it's a bunch of just volumes here just to make... I was planning to make this video first without anything in this window at all. But now I'm here, and it doesn't really affect what I was talking about at all. So where is the track? I mean, I've saved down the track here, or I've told the project already to save it at 12 minutes. What is it, like 13 minutes maybe? Yeah, 13 minutes. And the actual track is the thing that we see here. So this is the track. I only use a loop. I like to do it in that way for these projects, because it gives me a challenge as well. Like, how do you actually make like a psytrance track, like a proper psytrance track with all its effects, all its like things that are just happening all the time? How do you actually do that without actually like doing any advanced automations, and not like simple automations like this, just attenuating volumes of sounds, or a few sounds actually? I mean, already looking at these dots here, which are on and off for samples. Already, just looking at these 4 seconds, it's like hundreds of on and off things. And I could never write this at all. I could never write this. It's like too much. It's too advanced. And the whole point of this is not about writing. Knowing actually what's happening, is the point of this for me is actually use it as a game almost, and I'm coming to that in a moment. All I need to know is that all the signals are quantized or very close to quantization, and I need to know a little bit of how they are affecting each other, and of course I know that because I built this. So here we are. This is the system. Actually, there is one more thing which I'm gonna find right now. Here it is. So this is the system here. As you can see, 28 sliders, they are moving. Here we have a bunch of LFOs. Not all of them are interconnected. And here we have like a digit display. And here we have, I don't know what to call it really. like in another project, I made this one into a sequencer actually. But for now, it's just like a on and off box. And actually these lights here, they are actually affecting each other. So it's like when this one... The thing is, I don't remember here how I linked it. It doesn't really matter. I just know generally how I linked it. Next video, maybe I do one from beginning. But every time these lights are being turned on and off, they are also affecting each other, and all in different ways. For example, maybe this light is turned off, then that light goes on. And maybe this one also links to this one, and links to this one. And I link them, like, intertwine them a little bit. And that I did when I was listening to the track. I have, like, already 10 versions of this track, which is a bit annoying, but whatever. Yeah. So they are affecting each other, and I know they are affecting each other in a quantized manner. At the same time, these values are being triggered by all kinds of things here. Like, for example, we can see, what is this one triggered by? It has two connections, yeah, two links, and one is to DF LFO, and the other one is dashboard. Yeah, so this one is being affected by this one. And oops, here we have all the things. And the other was the DFLFO. Where is it? DFLFO, here it is. So it's quite advanced. So it's like every time this one goes up and down, this one moves. So we can see actually here on this fast movement is actually corresponding with this light here. Yeah, so we can also see in the digits that this system is like fully resonating with itself. It's never stopping, and that is because some clever routings. I think somewhere there is some kind of random thing. Actually, this one is random, 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 and this one is also random. But because I attenuate the bass and the min and the max amount of the signal, it becomes like controlled random, so to say. Also as well, all these sliders, I remember when I made this project here, it's like I linked all of them to like one LFO, but I chose different mappings, which I talked about. I talked about it on my Facebook. So all of these sliders are like linked to one LFO at first. I don't remember which one. Let's see which one it is. Oh fuck, this one had three links. Maybe that was the other project. Sorry. It doesn't really matter. Like they're all like intertwined in a way. I don't really remember anymore. All I know is that these numbers are very good to take and put on things. Very reactive, like it feels like they are more reactive than the other things. I don't know, I might be totally wrong, but it's just a feeling. Like I made these different windows like just to get different ideas. Like this one is not part of Fruit Loops, and this one is not part of Fruit Loops, and not this one either. I mean, they are part of Fruit Loops because it's dashboard, but I choose to lay out this. You can add new things here, like sliders and buttons and switches and blah blah blah. You can create your own MIDI controller inside of this one. Very interesting device. Also, we can see that the system is actually also turning on and off the LFOs themselves. So the LFOs are affecting each other, they are being affected by this, which are like totally intertwined. At the same time, they are also being affected when they are on and off, which is creating like a jitter effect inside the very system. It's like stopping a bit for a while until something else takes over. And all of these things, like all of these movements, you can also see on them that sometimes they are like moving super fast and sometimes slow, and they are like affecting each other. Like sometimes it sounds really good, but like, yeah, you can see that the signals are like, you can almost like hear a track by just looking at this. So that's it. Let's take a listen. I'm just gonna explain a few more things. Like, for example, here we have a delay that is later affecting this line here. And every time the delay is on, which is a very long delay, like da 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 da, it's like being gated. Every time those gate signals that are like hard cut because it's a gate signal, they are affecting these lights here, and these go, they go to like everything here and also to all these buttons. So that's like another very important aspect of this project. When you'll hear it when I start a track, is that the delay sound of the like metallic sound, or how to say it's like affecting everything when it comes, and also everything is affecting how often that delay sound is coming by like a modulation here. So let's listen to it and see where we're going with this. So remember, everything you hear, all the movements and everything, is being controlled by this system. I can show you a few things here. Here is one surge. This one doesn't have any movements, but this one has, I know. In the filters, no wind oscillator. Ah, here this one is moving the FM depth and the filters. No moving in the oscillators. I think I took that away actually, because it didn't really sound that well. Anyway, sometimes it's good to leave the oscillators just where they are. Okay. 1, 2, 3. So here we can see that I actually, we can hear this metallic delay sound. We can also see what's happening here in the glitch. that is the effect that is doing the gating. So listen to this sound and also watch this panel here, and you'll see that this sound is being bashed out here on these lights. You can almost see how it's like bashing out itself onto the other lights. This module here called Metal In. This one is like measuring the volume of the gate sound on number 4. So this is a very useful thing, this peak controller. that was a good example. Damn, it's really hard to speak with headphones. Okay, so that was a good example of like things happening. I wasn't really satisfied with the FM sounds, but doesn't really matter. It becomes better in next track. What I primarily wanted to show with this was that it works, and that it you can actually get super much more advanced complex if you want. You could build like 10 of these systems, or like in every channel you could have your own system. And now let's try, like, let's see what happens. Like, I think you remember the track now. Like, it was kind of sparse and not so much happening, but this track is a little bit like that. Let's change the rhythms a little bit on the rate buttons that are not moving. So this one is static, and this one, and this one, and this one belongs to something that we shouldn't touch really. So this one we put on a very low, and this one we put on a very high, and this one we put maybe at 3, and this one we put... This is the game, actually. You see here? Like, I'm just choosing new values, and I'm eager to hear what's gonna happen. So, let's see. Let's see if it sounds different. I might have fucked up this file, but it should sound a little bit different. Let's jump right in. I think I have like worked too much on this track, but now I made a tutorial with this version, but actually so much things are not changing. And the thing is, I don't remember anymore where I was, but it still sounds cool, and I mean the principle of this is endless. It's a very interesting concept, and I will keep on working on this until it's fucking perfected. You can also, you don't need to only like fiddle around with these knobs. You can fiddle around with anything. Like, every movement is like doing these things. So usually a lot of things are happening if I just take one value in the digit menu here and just go here and inverse the signal instead of like going forward like it does now. I can drastically change a lot of things as well, and maybe like this one over here, instead of this one being at this side, we just inverse it, so it's now acting more on this side. You have to think like this all the time. Like in this way of working, I cannot really go into an individual sound anymore and like, oh, I want that particular thing to go away. No, you have to like work with the whole system. Everything is being modulated. And even though I heard like other versions of this track that was like much more raw or like even better, like you have to like, if there's something you don't like, you have to go back into this. and rework it and find what's the problem in here. I find it very satisfying anyway. I like to work like that, because once you find what's causing something that you don't like, you have really mastered it, how to look for details in a very chaotic sense. So in next tutorial I'm gonna go through how to actually think when you produce a system like this, and what you need to choose and blah blah, and how to link it foremost. So that's it for today, and